easy ways of doing this because this really takes so much time. So what I normally do is I get a plate and two forks. Otherwise, with your clean hand, you have to do this, concentrate, meditate, okay, but I need plate and two forks, please. Or I can use one of these two forks. Okay, I feel closer to you when it's here. So, normally, okay, let me work on it. Play, okay? This way you don't have to soil your hands at the same time. Then just keep flattening it. This is good for when you want to put, let's say, no time even for selfie.
Oh,
this is just to make the flour rise. If you put too much, it's going to become bitter.
So it would be 1.5 tablespoon of flour. Right, Miss Nance?
For this much.
Okay. Then, okay,
so we can discuss the measurements later. We can discuss the measurements later. I want to go into techniques. So combining flour and baking powder will lighten up your batter, your dry rub. Actually, it's a dry rub. And then maybe just a little paprika for color. And my can I borrow some adobo powder? May I just borrow from Nicole? Not like too well. I'm not that coated, so the finer it is, the better. And you don't want to do this before you have a dinner date because you're going to really smell like adobo. So normally I would just add some olive. Rub it. Sorry, I'm not the kind of sanitary person. I use my hands. Okay. And then just put it through low, medium, high, and last low. Then it would already be a bit denser. Okay, can I just
what oil?
Just a little oil. If you want, some people add salt. So put it first on low, and then.